Janet Jackson is talking about her brother's death.
She says she knows who killed the King of Pop.
Have you ever met Dr. Conrad Murray?
Mm-mm.
Do you hold him responsible for Michael's death?
He was the one that was administering. I think he is responsible.
Janet also tells ABC's Robin Roberts Michael's drug problems were not a secret and that she tried to help him, but he refused her help. Janet says she was in New York City when she got the news he died. And months later, it's still hard for her to believe her brother is gone.
A Santa Fe artist calls Michael Jackson a friend and a confidant. Action 7 News anchor Natalie Swaby reveals more about the pair's almost two-decade-long relationship.
Yeah, and this is kind of the one that we ended up with.
In David Nordahl's studio.
That's the original art for the Heal the World.
Michael Jackson is everywhere.
And that was totally Michael's idea. I've been contacted by everybody over the years, but they all want to know dirt. They all want to know bad things about Michael.
For that reason, the artist never said a word about his friendship with Jackson until now.
The public was so poisoned by all the speculation about Michael, and they started on him right after Thriller.
Nordahl is speaking up to paint a much different picture of the pop star.
He was just a regular guy.
He met the music legend through a movie legend.
I had done a commission for Steven Spielberg, and Michael Jackson seen the painting hanging in Steven's office.
He says Jackson called him in February 1988 asking for an art lesson. Nordahl agreed to meet Jackson for the first time in Denver.
Then after that, he started talking about different projects that he would like me to work on.
Other fans of his work had to wait. Jackson had so many ideas, Nordahl worked on portraits for him for nearly two decades, often making many visits to meet Michael.
I spent extended periods of time, 2 and 3 weeks at a time.
And he says Michael Jackson would visit him too. Nordahl says it was Memorial Day weekend 2004 when Jackson and the kids came here to Santa Fe and managed to blend in here at this movie theater.
Not a single soul recognized him.
Nordahl credits that to Jackson wearing a disguise, plus the group snuck out the back door once the theater was clear.
You know, any of the rags would have paid $100,000 for a photograph of that, at least.
He says he would often forget he was sitting next to a megastar.
He would do these little quick dance steps like lightning, you know, and then all of a sudden I would realize, whoa, you know, this is Michael Jackson.
Now he is dealing with Michael's death.
I was just heartbroken. I mean, you know, when you're friends with, close friends with somebody for 21 years, it's pretty difficult. And the loss, the terrible loss, you know. These were original sketches.
It may not be the Michael Jackson the public remembers, but for this artist.
I don't know anything bad about Michael.
It's how he remembers his friend. In Santa Fe, Natalie Swaby, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Nordahl wants to see the artwork he did of Jackson end up in a museum. When it comes to past scandals and claims of abuse, Nordahl says they were lies made up by people seeking money.